positivity and about white magic, but he was heavily drawn into the black magic. And that was, for me, quite a shock. André Chambly was died in 2004, but he had this UK-based magical group known as Cultus Sabbati. Now, his magical grimoires get sold on the internet nowadays for prices of $600-$700 for each piece. He described his doctrine as transcendental sorcery, and he termed it as magical quintessence. But in reality, we can talk about ferocious kind of black magic. I mean, rate rights of ingress to really congress and aggress with the most demonic sorceress alphabet. So you can imagine, it was the first time and probably the only time I was on my own also, because I left my security out of this thing, and I said, you know, I'm in the hands of a brother, I'm not going to have any security with me. Otherwise, at all times, when I'm in the US, I usually have at least 6 bodyguards with me.
Was yeah. this something that maybe he was just trying to learn about? Do you think it's bad to even open that doorway just to learn about it?
A guy like him is not learning about it. He was obviously a member of the Cultus Sabbati, because he wanted me to recognize those symbols. And at the beginning, when I saw what it was, I kind of stepped back and said, Jesus. And then I said, Jesus, protect me. And then I said, because I really saw the essence of this demonic entity in front of me.
Okay.
I mean,
okay.
It was pretty satanic. So I said to him in a very, you know, just so he could, because he was testing me. He was bringing me inside this temple to test me, you know, if I was an Illuminati. And obviously I recognized what it was. I knew that it was connected to André Chambly. But I didn't want to say that to him immediately. So I said, oh, what is it? Memphis and Mizraim symbol or something? I played a little bit stupid. Okay?
Okay.
Just so I could get him off my back and then analyze the situation when we went back upstairs into the house. I mean, I was in this temple underground. I mean, I thought it's better to get out of here before I can start, you know.
Probably a good
when
idea.
We went back up into his house, a wonderful house, typical American, you know, very nice house. I mean, you're talking about a very respected member of the Freemasons of Denver and Colorado. He has a very respectable position, and he's also a very close friend of Nicolas Cage.
Okay.
Who is now interested in the Illuminati, so kind of got introduced to him and by a mutual friend, and obviously these days is kind of very interested in alchemy, and as I said, John Compact maybe is one of the most known alchemists in the US these days. But as I said, following André Chambly is something that obviously is not it's not for the faint-hearted, I would say.
Okay.
His grimoire is known as is called the Azotia, and Azotia is a work of breathtaking power and passion. I could see that those images were taken from the grimoire of André Chambly. I'm not an idiot. Okay. So when I went back upstairs after a little while, I said, "Listen, John, I know that is connected to André Chambly." But I said, you know how André Chambly died. He died choking himself. We don't even know how. But it wasn't a good way of dying. And also, the forces that he was evoking, I will not say they are in line with what a genuine Rosicrucian and a genuine Illuminati who is defending the light as brother Lucius, you know, as a fratres Lucius, we learn to defend the light. And at that point, he started to understand that I wasn't on his side, because I think that he had probably the impression that I might be somebody who was, you know, playing on both sides. I didn't, you know, want to criticize him too much. I just put out the thing. We went up into the kitchen, had some breakfast. I said, listen, I understood this is connected to André Chambly. But I don't, I'm not really, I have been connected to Andrew Chamblee in the past, because I was connected to Andrew Chamblee in the past when I was within the folds of the evil side of the Illuminati. And I was connected to Andrew Chamblee myself personally through another brother of Memphis and Mizraim, who is Dr. Nikolai Fritzbold, another very evil black magician from Norway who nowadays is living in Brazil. And from São Paulo is kind of directing most of the Satanism, which is widespread in Brazil and in South America. And so we are talking here about a real war between angel and demons. This is not just a book of Dan Brown. This is a real war.
Wow.
What comes out from the books of Dan Brown is like a projection of the reality on a much more light scale. The reality is actually even more delirious and more, much more interesting than what fiction is.
Let's talk about the Vatican.
A church that claims to be the church of Jesus Christ, okay, should not be built upon stone, but upon the beliefs in the heart. And I think that is appalling that for centuries the Vatican had this kind of power over several states in central Italy, and they were able to basically rule over the whole Sacred Roman Empire. Like, only in some moments of history, some emperors tried to oppose the Vatican power, and even tried, like in the case of Frederick II Barbarossa, to invade Rome, so they could finally unify and free Europe from this burden. It's a very powerful tool of manipulation. So the Midwest that claims to be the Bible Belt, and they are generally the Bible Belt, and I respect them very much for their belief in the Bible, should understand better the level of manipulation that unfortunately they are subject to. Giordano Bruno, one of our great Illuminati of all times, was sentenced on the stake for starting to talk about certain secrets and to finally talk about the science of God. No, that was not permitted that was not permitted, so Giordano Bruno had to be burned on the stake. But fortunately, Giordano Bruno was somebody who had been traveling a lot around Europe, and he went to meet John Dee. John Dee, as we know, created the Enochian language together with Edward Kelly, and is also known as the first 007 of our history. That was his code name with Queen Elizabeth. And that was because, obviously, entities were also used for military aspects. And even Giordano Bruno himself, he got in a trap because he was in Venice. He never thought he could be arrested by the Vatican in Venice, because Venice always had a very independent way of being. But instead, unfortunately, because somebody close to him betrayed him, because Giordano Bruno refused to give him certain magical secrets, he betrayed him and got him arrested. And at the end, the Vatican put so much pressure on the Republic of Venice that Giordano Bruno had to be brought to Rome. As I said, the Illuminati are real, and there is not only dark Illuminati, but there is very positive Illuminati, and thanks to them, we have society as we have it today. So, you see, if people were to tell me the real Illuminati on top, are they good or are they evil? I would say that they are neutral, because they go beyond good and evil, being at that level of understanding. It's a pyramid of power. Freemasonry, this is like, okay, if we draw a circle in front of us, okay? Now, on the external part of the circle, you have the profane world, okay? Mm-hmm. Which is you, which is the people outside there who are not Freemasons, who are just normal folks.
Right.
Now, the first level of attainment of secret knowledge is Freemasonry. So then you enter into one circle within the circle, okay?
Okay.
Then if you want to go further, you have to be You can't really knock on the door. I mean, on Freemason, you can always, you know, ask a friend, oh, he's a Freemason, maybe you can sponsor me, can I join?